Welcome back, everyone. We have already discussed usual virtual private servers or regular VPS in my previous video, but I'm sure you probably heard about cloud VPS. So let's just jump into it and break down cloud VPS versus usual VPS. VPS and a cloud VPS are the same thing, and you'll be right. A regular VPS and a cloud VPS are kind of like twin brothers. They're both based on the same virtualization technology, and they both represent smaller slices of a bigger pie / server served to us as separate private servers. But at the same time, a VPS and a cloud VPS are quite different. Today we'll go over their main differences and of course talk about which service will be a better pick for you. Now, VPS stands for Virtual Private Server, and you get full control over that one single server. And then we've got Cloud VPS. This is when you pay a monthly fee and rent a small part of a much larger network. The question still stands though, which one should you use and why? For a person that's just getting into web hosting, all these different terms can be, well, a bit tricky. And to keep things simple, just remember that cloud is a group of high-performance dedicated servers united into a single compute network. And now, the main distinction. A regular VPS is a part of a single dedicated server, while a cloud VPS is a part of a cloud compute network. But what does it mean for you? Well, the fact that cloud VPS can be much more powerful than a regular VPS, and if you expect significant traffic growth, you should definitely go with cloud VPS. Setting up both a regular VPS and a cloud VPS can be quite challenging, and well, you should be ready for it. Luckily, many cloud providers offer cloud VPS with a set of pre-installed additional software that can ease your task. For example, you can buy a cloud VPS with a pre-installed control panel and work with it as you would with ordinary shared hosting. And it's really simple. Now, in 2021, privacy and security should always be the number one concern. Good news! You get plenty of that with the VPS. Thanks to the one user, one server approach, only you will have access to it, which makes it almost impossible for third parties to get sneak peeks of your stuff. The VPS concept is not perfect, however, and there are some things that we'll need to address. The biggest turnoff is limited scalability. You'll be able to get your hands on more resources, of course, but only with the limits of that one server. And Cloud VPS is much more scalable as it is a part of a huge cloud compute network. Another big distinction is that Cloud VPS is much more reliable than a regular VPS. I bet you wouldn't like to find yourself in a situation where your VPS just shuts down. If you have a regular VPS and the dedicated server is connected to fails, you won't be able to help it. Your websites just won't work until the provider fixes the main server. So when will you need to worry about this? See, when there is a traffic surge, the server might not be able to handle it. And once it goes down, the websites or apps running on it will become unavailable. And believe me, you don't want to be in a situation where the server is malfunctioning and there is no way of getting your site back to life. Good news is that you don't need to worry about such things with Cloud VPS. Compute nodes form core of resources within a cloud environment. If one of the cloud compute nodes fails, your cloud VPS is instantly recreated on another cloud compute node. And the best part of it is that it happens so quickly that you won't even notice. That's why you should definitely choose cloud VPS if you want enhanced reliability. So, what's there to do when you lack the necessary skills but are still interested in web hosting? Well, that's where Cloud VPS comes in. It's a more popular service because Cloud VPS allows you to get started fairly quickly. Choose a Cloud VPS with the control panel you are used to. I recommend Plus control panel, as with it you'll get a convenient Cloud VPS easy to work with even if you're just starting out and aren't a tech pro yet. Got the website and looking for best hosting options? Great, Cloud VPS has got you covered. That's the general idea behind this service. Flexibility is crucial as well. Unlike a usual VPS, a Cloud VPS service doesn't limit you in any way when it comes to expanding and adding more resources to your server. All that is going to take is a request and an extra fee. But before you move on, let me elaborate a bit. The resources will be allocated between different users, true, but that doesn't mean that all those other accounts will be eating away your computing power. Every single user gets the fair share, and with a decent provider, you won't even be in a situation when you don't get the resources you paid for. And that's a good reason not to trust suspiciously cheap services, by the way. So why should you consider Cloud VPS over VPS? I've got one reason: dependability. If your /part of the network fails, your websites, apps, and everything in between will be automatically transferred to another slot. That way, you won't have to wake up realizing that it's gonna take tons of work to restart everything on a new server. With that being said, let me tell you what Cloud VPS is best for. It prevails as a scalable solution, of course, and that means pretty much any website or business that you're planning on expanding might be wise to start with Cloud VPS. Online stores do require a lot of resources to run, and with a VPS, you'd have to think about migrating to a much bigger and more expensive server. With Cloud VPS, though, expanding and adding more resources will be like a walk in the park. Most leading providers offer lots of flexible plans that allow expanding the way you want to. If Cloud VPS seems like the best option for you, just VPS might be a good place to start. Don't go cheap when it comes to Cloud VPS. I can't stress this once again. Anything available for less than $10 a month shouldn't even be considered. In fact, run away from it as far as you can, because the quality of the service will leave a lot to be desired. Besides, low-priced hosting services are usually less than ideal in terms of security. Summing up, if you're a software developer or just in love with coding, a Cloud VPS can be of great help. Let me ask you this. How many times have you been in a situation where the deadline is looming closer and the computer that you got at the office is too slow to get things done in time? Well, with powerful Cloud VPS, that won't be a problem. It's safe to say that video game developers and companies that work on mobile apps will also find a Cloud VPS to be a worthy investment. But you got to know what you're doing. Otherwise, it'll be just money, time, and energy going down the drain. Getting a website up and running isn't a very easy task. Be brutally honest with yourself and only go with VPS if you're 100% confident you'll pull it off. That's pretty much it. I really hope that I was able to help you understand the differences between VPS and Cloud VPS. It all comes down to your personal needs and requirements at the moment. My biggest advice to beginners is don't be afraid to experiment. Take the first step. Web hosting services aren't that expensive, and you might want to test the waters before committing to either one of these options. And to refresh your memory just briefly before we say goodbye, here is a quick verdict on the Cloud VPS versus VPS wars. Cloud VPS is highly scalable, safe, and reliable. If you've got a startup and hope of getting bigger in the nearest future, this will be your go-to service. Even if all the pros make Cloud VPS a bit more expensive than a normal VPS, trust me, it's definitely worth it. VPS, in turn, is very private, secure, and is almost entirely standalone. From a financial standpoint, virtual private servers are also a better deal. But remember, you'll be limited to that one server, and if it stops working, so will your website. Plus, if you don't have the skill set and don't know the first thing about setting everything up properly, a VPS will turn into a hosting nightmare. Anyway, thanks for watching, and don't forget to check back with us to catch all the latest videos. See you in the next one!